Nurse Wellington wheeled him back to room 22. "Nurse Z is resting her ears," he said. "Now, young man, time for your medicine." "No, thank you," said Filbert, and sealed his lips tight. Closer and closer came the shimmering spoon. It could not be avoided. He turned into a giraffe.
"Tee-hee-hee!" came the voice of Filbert MacFee. "Just try to reach my mouth now!"
Nurse Wellington retreated. "Nurse Beluga," he called. "Tall order for you in room 22. Nurse Beluga stomped down the hall. "Tall order, you say? I'm taller than orders. I'm taller than elevators. I'm taller than most any patient around here." She rounded the corner and spotted the giraffe. "I'm not taller than that." Filbert loomed near the ceiling. Nurse Beluga shook her finger at patient MacFee. "Young man, this looming has got to stop. I shall fetch a ladder." A long neck followed her down the hall. Nurse Beluga came back. Filbert straightened up. She parked the ladder at the bed and climbed up hand over hand. Just then, Dr. Kebab stopped by on his rounds.
"What have you done with Filbert MacFee?"
Nurse Wellington handed him the chart.
"Well, well," said Dr. Kebab. "Not well at all," said Nurse Beluga. "This boy changes more than a hospital sheet."
She faced the giraffe.
"Now listen here, you. This is a hospital, not a zoo. No giraffes allowed."
The giraffe kissed her nose and changed into a grizzly bear. Nurse Beluga swayed in the air. The bear snuggled under the covers. Nurse Beluga climbed down and clenched her teeth.
"Bear or not, it's 8 a.m. Your pulse must be taken."
She picked up a paw.
"Go away," growled the grizzly. "I'm hibernating."
"Hibernating now, is it?" said Nurse Beluga. She threw back the covers. "Winter is over. And furthermore, Filbert, this is a hospital, not a..."
"Oh, bother," said the bear. "I won't sleep a wink."
And he turned into an orangutan with droopy, sad eyes. Dr. Kebab scribbled on the chart, trying to keep up.
"Most interesting case," he muttered. "Now, Nurse Beluga, can you change him back?"
"Now listen here, you,"
Nurse Beluga began.
"This is a hospital, not a zoo. No orangutans allowed."
But the orangutan crouched low without a sound. Nurse Beluga went nose to nose with the ape.
"Hello in there! What have you done with Filbert MacFee?"
The orangutan blinked one giant tear.
"Oh dear," said Nurse Beluga. "What have I done to Filbert MacFee?"
She patted dry his tear. Dr. Kebab crouched to examine the patient.
"Ouch!" he grunted. "My knees!"
The orangutan grunted back happily. His furry arm slid under the pillow and brought out a cracker for Dr. Kebab.
"For me?"
said the doctor. "Don't mind if..."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.